Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2015 set 3 guys. Okay, so the question is, suppose U is the power set of S. Okay, so they are saying U is the power set of S. Okay, so where S is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are total 6 elements in this. So indirectly in the power set we are going to have 2 power 6 elements, right? Which is nothing but 64 elements or 64 items will be there, right? Yes. Okay. So for any T belongs to U. So they are saying T is a particular item in U. Let mod T denotes the number of elements in T and T dash denotes the complement of T. Okay. So for any T, comma R. Okay, so they are taking one more variable R. I think it's not used till date, right? Yes. Okay, so T comma R belongs to U. Let T by R be the set of all elements in T. So which are not in R? So which one of the following is true? Okay, so T by R means the set of all elements in T which are not in R. Yeah, the exact it is nothing but T minus R guys in normal traditional sets, right? Yes. Okay, so let us try to analyze the question once again. Okay, yes, so they are taking a particular item from this and they are trying to complement it, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, yeah, that's what they are doing, right? So for any T, okay, so now we need to check these conditions. Okay, so for all X belongs to, okay, so for any variable X will belong to U of, okay, so U of mod X is equals to mod X dash. Okay, so what they are saying is if you take any set, this first condition will be satisfied. I think this condition is one of the most easiest condition, right? Yes, to eliminate. Because whenever we are talking about this particular subset, so basically if 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are there, so initially we start with nothing, means all will be zeros, and you will end up with all ones, right? Yes. So if you take most of the cases, will be in this way, right? So all zeros and only this guy is 1. So in that way, so here the traditional value, that is nothing but T mod T is equals to 1, whereas mod T complement will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here both of them are not equal, right? Yes. So with that simple understanding, we can clearly say that this option is wrong, right? That's clear, right? Yes. Okay. So we can say that A is there wrong. Okay. So moving on to option B. So option B says that for some value of X belongs to U of some value of Y belongs to U. Okay, so I think is there any separation things guys, or it is in this way only? Okay, so belongs to U, some value of Y belongs to U, so mod of X equal to 5, mod of Y equal to 5, and X intersection, okay, so X intersection Y is equals to 5. So they are saying there are some values in this way. Okay, so the most crazy thing here is, so if I am taking intersection and if I am saying that in X, I am selecting 5 items from this and I am selecting in Y also, I am selecting 5 items. And if I perform intersection, how come it will be empty guys? I'm not getting the idea here. So if you take any 5 elements here, so I took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now I need to take another 5 elements, but there is only one element which is not common, right? Yes. So if I take any other element, it will become common. So how come it will be empty? So with that simple analysis, I think we can compulsorily say that that is wrong, right? Yes. So not even for one, it is possible, right? So they are saying for some value, but it is not even possible for one value. Hence, how can we say? Okay, so option C says that for all X belongs to U and for all X belongs to, sorry, Y belongs to U, X equal to 2. So if a count of X equal to 2 and count of Y equal to 3, X minus Y equal to 5. Okay, so again, this X minus 5 is almost equal to disjoint set, right? They are trying to say indirectly. Yes. So basically, if you observe here carefully, so what are they saying, guys? So they are saying whatever we take in X, so they are going to be mandatorily in Y is what they are saying, right? But I think we can write some examples in that way, right? So in X, I will keep 1 and 2. In Y, I will keep 3, 4 and 5. So if I perform division operation for these two, I will get 1, 2 as a result, and it is not satisfying this condition, whereas this is 1 and 2 and here 3 items. So this option also seems to be wrong, right? Yes. So now moving on to option D. Okay, so option D says that for all values of x belongs to you and for all values of x belongs to, y belongs to you. Okay. So now they are saying x by y is equals to y complement of x. So few students will already be like, why am I considering this set? Most students will be like that, right? The only reason why I'm considering this set is if we try to analyze this set, it will be a bit tough, guys. So that is the reason why I'm taking a smaller set, so that will be easy for us, right? Yes. Okay. So whenever we are trying for this, so let us take the same example, guys. So 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5. Okay, so nothing is common. So when I perform subtraction operation, what will I get, guys? I will get 1, 2 at the end, right? Yes. So if I apply complement for this, what are the values which are left out, guys? So 1 is left out, 2 is left out, 6 is left out. Okay, so from that value, I need to divide it by x complement. So this will left out with, what will be the values which will be left out? Just give me a second. Did I miss any value here? That's it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, right? Yes. So if I apply subtraction in between these two, so 6, 6 will cancel and I will get 1, 2. So basically on the left hand side, it is 1, 2 and on the right hand side, it's 1, 2. So most probably this is the potential correct answer, guys. So D is the correct answer. So basically for option A, B and C, I was able to prove that they are wrong with one example. And that one example only proved that D is correct. Got it? Yes. So our example is a bit lucky in this case, right? Yes. And I know that few students will be like, why did I select this set? So basically any set you select, the concept is the same, right? So that is the reason why I selected a smaller set rather than taking that 64 set and confusing myself, right? Yes. Okay. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.